यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम् अधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहम् परित्राणाय साधूना विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे।
गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर लविंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू टेक फ्यू क्लासेस rather few lectures on Indian heritage. As you know, India has a very rich culture of, you know, our heritage is very rich and it has been recognized by the world. One organization, that is UNESCO, it is called United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO. Can make out from here, United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. These are designated authorized bodies to identify and delineate the world heritage sites spread throughout the world. So India has many historical sites which are of international reckoning, and I have taken this topic intentionally so that it could be one of the guidelines for those children who are preparing for civil services examination. Of late, the craze for civil services has increased manifold. And in the name of this craze, and seeing the popularity of the civil services examination, there are so many markets who have started plundering children of their scarce resources. If you go to Delhi, of course, Delhi is the central point where lots of coaching institutes, in the name of giving guidance and coaching, they plunder a lot of money from the poor children. Those who can afford, no problem. But those who are having meager resources, it becomes very difficult for them to organize few lakhs of rupees. So, I am dedicating this lecture, maybe it might take two or three lectures because the topic is very big. So I would be discussing in detail. मैं पूरी विस्तृत तरीके से discuss करूँगा कि prelims में जो question आते हैं और जो mains में question आते हैं इस chapter से Indian heritage से करीब करीब 15-20 question आते हैं prelims में, और कहाँ पे question छिपा हो रहता है, कैसे उसकी तैयारी की जाए, इसका समावेश मैं अपने lecture में करूँगा. And that would be very fruitful to you. You try to listen this video from top, beginning to end, and you will just come to know the very roots. It's called the sutra. It's not very difficult how to read those, and the material is available in yearbook, India yearbook, or you can also call every year India yearbook is published. Malayalam Manorama is the another one. Either you take Malayalam Manorama or you take India Yearbook, which is published by Government of India, Ministry Publication Division. So it is published by same organization which publishes Kurukshetra and Yojana. It would be very nice for the children to prepare, and without any hassle, without any pressure, how to study, I'll just let you know step by step. Now, almost around 38 sites have been identified by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site in India. There are 38 World Heritage Sites located in India. These include 30 cultural sites. Cultural sites means those sites, for instance, temples, architectural masterpieces, caves, you know, which we are going to discuss in detail. And 7 natural site and 1 mixed criteria oriented site. Now listen very carefully. Manas Wildlife Sanctuary was listed as being in danger in 1992. Thereafter, but it was removed in 2011. Following, Hampi was added to the list of World Heritage Sites in danger in 1999. Now let us see, if you read India Air book, you must have studied. I'll just tell you in chronological order, ek sequence bhi bataunga ki hamare desh mein har kisi ko pata hai. And it's a very normal question, you must be knowing or you may be knowing ki Kumbh Mela har 12 saal lagta hai. Kaun kaun sites pe mela lagte hain? Allahabad, Haridwar, Nasik and Ujjain. The choice would be in prelims examination, four questions would be there, four options would be there. And nowadays, the questions are slightly tricky. They will not give you straight these things. They will give you five or six names in which one would be either 1, 2, 3 or 2, 3, 4, none of these, either of these, all of these kind of things there. But what we have to remember, these sites where Kumbh Mela is organized after every 12 years. Allahabad, Ujjain, Haridwar and Nasik. These are the four places where Kumbh Mela is organized every 4 years, 12 years. Now just imagine, if you don't know these four names, Allahabad, now it is not no more Allahabad, it is Prayagraj. Originally its name was Prayagraj, Ujjain, Haridwar and Nasik. Haridwar is in Uttarakhand, Prayagraj in Uttar Pradesh, Nasik is in Maharashtra and Ujjain is in Madhya Pradesh. These are the four places where sacred Kumbh Mela, every after 12 years it is organized. So this is one question and just you have to remember once. Idea is very clear. Now listen, the first site is Ajanta Caves. It is roughly around 250 km from Mumbai, Ajanta Caves. What a magnificent structural design. This cave is dedicated to Buddhist monks and monasteries. If you ever go to Ajanta Caves, of course every Indian must go to these sites. Maybe for the excursion point of view, but those who have not gone, you must try to go at least once in life. You will just come to know. Today we are craving and crying that we are children of the modern era. If you look at the paintings, if you look at the classical painting being depicted or the engravings on the walls and the roof ceilings, you can just make out. I have used the word, it is simply mesmerizing. It is something, you know, hallucinating. Is it possible? Was it possible then? Centuries back, somewhere in BC, they had done that. So, what we have to remember? Where is Ajanta Cave? That simple question is, where is Ajanta Cave? Answer is, it is in Maharashtra. It is in Maharashtra. It was roughly around 2nd century BC to 6th century. As you know, this period saw the massive expansion of Buddhism. So, the monks started living in the monasteries and in the caves. And there, while staying in the caves in the monasteries, they depicted beautiful part of their art and architecture. So, what we are reading is nothing but simply answer and question. Answer of what? The question which are going to be posed while we prepare for civil service examination. Many children, they simply get bogged down. They simply, you know, have created a big hullabulla that UPSC is a very big thing, very difficult thing. Of course, it's a very difficult thing. But if we can systematically plan, children can proceed. I don't know how can somebody say that you will crack it. But they can definitely proceed in the direction of success. Ajanta Caves are the Buddhist caves built in two phases. And mind you, the source from where I have taken is Google. You don't have to go anywhere. Which you can find In India Yearbook, every year it is published by the Ministry of Publication Division of Ministry of Culture. And so this topic pertains to Department of Culture, Ministry of Environment, Culture and Wildlife Affairs. Presently it is headed by Mr. Javadekar. So just imagine, and I'll tell you what are the question and what are, should be the pattern of your studies. Ajanta caves are Buddhist caves built in two phases. Now the question would be, Ajanta caves are dedicated to spread of Christianity. If you just stick it on Christianity, your answer is wrong. And these days, I think it is negative marking era which has started. When we took up civil services examination, that time it was not negative marking. But now because seeing lots of children, you know, moving towards civil services preparation in a whole, they have started negative marking. The first was from region of Emperor Ashoka. You all must be knowing that Ashoka, after that battle of Kalinga, where there was massive mayhem, and it is a legend that he killed 99 of his brothers. And finally, after seeing so much of bloodshed, in the quest of peace, he embraced his Buddhism. The second further addition was made during 5th and 6th centuries AD of the Gupta period. That you know very well, Gupta period is also called the golden period of Indian history, golden era of Indian history and administration. The caves depict richly decorated frescoes painting, frescoes, the wall painting, reminiscent of Singriya paintings and sculptures in Sri Lanka. There are 31 rock cut caves monuments which are unique representation of religious art of Buddhism. Now just see, while I am reading, it's not merely reading a text but posing lots of questions before you. These days, if you read scientifically and if you read systematically, you can really have sumptuous amount of knowledge from the resources which is given. By purchasing a book of, I think yearbook is costing around 100 odd rupees, very thick one, maybe around 30-40 chapters are there. Those yearbook coupled with Kurukshetra and Yojana, plus whole lot of series of NCERT books starting from class 5th standard onward, I think that makes complete education for GS. So Ajanta caves pertains to Buddhism, and it the period stretches from 2nd century BC to 6th century AD, by the end of the Gupta period, Gupta dynasty. So this was the first Ajanta caves. It is in Maharashtra. Ellora caves, it is again in Maharashtra. The period of its maybe exact period that it was spread around, it was 600 to 1000 AD. Ellora caves, also known as Ellora complex, are cultural mix of religious art of Buddhism, Hinduism and Jainism. My dear children, you must be knowing that Buddhism and Jainism are offshoots of Hinduism. Have you seen ever a banyan tree? Kabhi aapne bargat ke ped ko dekhe hoge. To bargat ke ped ke paas kya hota hai? Jab ped vishal hota hai, to uske offshoots nikalte hain. Bahut sare offshoots nikalte hain. And those offshoots, they have, you know, tentacle sort of creatures or structures, or you can say just like, you know, that hangs from some of the branches and get affixed to the soil. And from after getting affixed to the soil, that had the propensity to form roots from there. Same and similar, or I should say identical, is the origin of Buddhism and Jainism from Hinduism. Hinduism is the mother religion of Sikhism of late. In the ancient India, it was Buddhism and Jainism. Buddhism was founded by Lord Buddha, Mahavira, and Jainism was formed by Lord Mahavira. So Ellora caves, also known as Ellora complex, cultural mix of religious arts of Buddhism, Hinduism and Jainism. So if it is a judicious or having semblance of all the religion, three religions, Buddhism of course is the parent one, and Hinduism, and from there Buddhism and Jainism. So in Ellora Caves you find the semblance of all three religions. 34 monasteries and temples is sculptured. What is sculpturing? Sculpturing means carving out from the stone, chiseling out each and every part of the stone. जैसे कहते हैं ना छेनियाँ थोड़े से काट काट के. These are all rocks, and from there they just made it hollow and the structure of its own design, of its own pattern. Into rock walls of high basalt cliff are seen along with length of 2 kilometers, dated 600 to 1000 AD. There are different reflections of artistic creation of the ancient civilization of India. हमारी इंडियन सिविलाइजेशन कितनी रिच, कितनी वेरिएटेड और कितनी वाइब्रेंट है ये अजंता एलोरा केव्स देखने के बाद पता चलता है. इट इज मस्ट फॉर यू. यू शुड नॉट वेस्ट योर मनी ऑन एनी ऑफ द थिंग्स, बट एवर यू गेट अ टाइम, मे बी फॉर 10 days या 5 days, यू मस्ट गो टू महाराष्ट्र एंड स्ट्रेट वे हेड टूवर्ड्स अजंता एलोरा केव्स. यू विल बी कमिंग वेरी रिच फ्रॉम देयर. You will have so much of love and affection. आजकल के जो लड़के बोलते हैं ना टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग, जब वो सब जगह देख लेंगे तो इस देश से अपने आप प्यार हो जाएगा. हमारी माँ, हमारी धरती माँ, हमारी भारत माँ कितनी खूबसूरत रंगों से पिरो रखा है अलग अलग जगहों को, इन केव को देखने के बाद पता चलता है. Now let us move to, so I gave you some of the ideas how to read. All the points which are listed there are potential questions. So you have to read underneath. You have to just underline each and every sentence. They will ask you a question. Ajanta and Ellora Caves are dedicated to Islam. If you write yes, you are gone. If you write it is dedicated to tribe of mix, Ellora Caves, Ajanta Caves basically dedicated to Buddhism. Ajanta Caves are tribe mix of Hinduism, Buddhism and Jainism. So once you read this, your idea would be amply clear. You don't have to take any big coaching in our UPSC. Does not ask this coaching wala what questions to be set up. They just take what government publications are. And so what you should read, only government publications. And these are the only authentic publications. These coaching people, what they do, in order to make their material very bulky, they put lot of material in that, you know, reading material, and consequently it becomes voluminous, it becomes torturous for the children to study. Keep those ideas. Take one yearbook every year, unless and until you complete your UPSC examination or till you have the quest of achieving results in UPSC. Third is Agra Fort, you know that. It was in 16th century. That was the World Heritage Site, it was there. We did not discuss in detail, 16th century. Agra Fort, also known as the Red Fort at Agra. There is a Red Fort. One is in Delhi and the second is in Agra. The Agra Fort was built by Akbar and Red Fort was built by Shahjahan. So Shahjahan Fort, which was built in Delhi, comes later. Because I think Akbar was the great grandfather of Shahjahan. Also known as the Red Fort of Agra represents Mughal opulence and power in the center of peace of their empire. It is inscribed the UNESCO World Heritage List in 1982. So nothing great is to be read about it. It is situated on the river Yamuna and it is built of sandstone. Very remarkable. All the fortresses, whether it is Fatehpur Sikri or Red Fort of Agra or Red Fort of Delhi, these are made up of red sandstone covering length of 2.5 kilometer. It is surrounded by a moat which encloses several palaces, towers and mosques, and it was built by Akbar. It was later, the impressive structure was built by Shah Jahan in Delhi. Now, the impressive structure was built within the presence of fort or the Khas Mahal. If you ever go to Delhi, Red Fort, where on the from the rampart of Taj rampart of Red Fort, Prime Minister delivers his speech, that place encompasses different kind of areas, which probably was the seat of power for the Mughals, in which it is Diwane Khas, in which only few people, which were close coterie of the king Shah Jahan, they were allowed to sit there. Diwane Aam, like a public place, Aam people, and Nagina Masjid is there inside. Now, they might ask you, where is Nagina Masjid situated? So if you read our National World Heritage Sites, Nagina Masjid would be identified. You will find it where. But once you have read this, Nagina Masjid, they have picked up the question. I faced this question in prelims, I don't know which year. These monuments are remarkable for the fusion of Persian art and Tumerid and Indian art forms. Now the most important part is, they are not going to ask you the very intricate, but they will ask you very soft questions. What were the architectural design? Now if I ask you, what is the architectural design of Taj Mahal? Many children, they get mesmerized. That particular design is called Pitra Dura. If you read NCERT books, most of the teacher I ask, when I take their interview, what is the architectural design of Taj Mahal? They just get confused. Sir, I don't know, it is Taj Mahal, it was made in India, so Indian design? No. That particular design has a name, that is called Pitra Dura. So here also, the kind of architectural design which was used to construct Red Fort and Nagina Masjid, or for that matter, the structure of Diwane Aam and Diwane Khas, is Persian and Tumerid, with the buffer zone separating the two monuments. So these are the Mughal Empire period, which have got significance in the World Heritage List. Now let us come back to Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal, one of the seven wonders of the world, is a mausoleum. Mausoleum kya hota hai? Jahan pe dafnaya jata hai koi. A funerary mosque. It was built by Emperor Shah Jahan in memory of his third wife, Begum Mumtaz Mahal. And now just see, Begum Mumtaz Mahal, because the entire world knows about Taj Mahal. So, ek question to isse banta hai. Normally, every year, either in PT or in mains, or somewhere in some form, either it could be Mumtaz Mahal was the first wife, or 24th wife, or third wife, they will ask one question. So, Mumtaz, it was constructed in the memory of his wife, who was third wife of Shah Jahan, Begum Mumtaz, who had died in 1631. A large edifice made in which white marble, typical Mughal architecture style, and combines elements from Persian, Islamic and Indian architectural style. This much acclaimed masterpiece was built over 16-year period between 1631 to 1648. Huge time. And the architect, Ustad Ahmad Lahori, supported by several thousand artists, under the guidance of an imperial committee, it was inscribed in the UNESCO World Heritage List in 1983. So, and the famous Mughal Garden, it is having the, in front of Taj Mahal, it is having famous Mughal Garden. So the question arises, famous Mughal Garden is at the backyard of Taj Mahal, or in front of the Taj Mahal, or the backside of River Yamuna. Taj Mahal is situated on river Yamuna or Saraswati or Ganges. But if you ever just have a glimpse and look, cursory glance over these things, you will come to know that how simple these are. The answer of the question which you know, if you know it, it is very simple. If you don't know it, it looks as big as mountain. So my dear children, these are the ways that you have to read. And thus I gave you that what is the architectural design of Taj Mahal. Most of the children, it has been inscribed, it has been written in the class 9th or 10th standard book. Now it is octagonal layout marked by four exclusive minarets at four corners with a pristine elevation of central bulbous dome below, which are the tombs are laid in an underground chamber. Calligraphic inscriptions. If you ever see Taj Mahal very closely, calligraphic matlab likhne ki jo banavat hoti hai, jo architectural pattern hai uske upar. Calligraphic inscription encrusted polychromatic pitradora. Pitradora. It is called pitradora. I just now told you. That is the architectural design or the calligraphic pattern which is inscribed on Taj Mahal. On the four minarets, on the main structural dome, central dome of Taj Mahal. So just remember, Pitradora. It is also called Pitradora. Pitradura. Dura. A decorative band of floral arabesque glorify the monument's graphic beauty and provide a picture impressive by the viewer. So my dear boys, my dear loving children, when you prepare for an examination, as I told you, my favorite passion is that you should read NCERT books as many times as you feel like. Now I have started with the Indian heritage, world heritage. Indian heritage. What are the heritage that we inherit from our ancestors? What our forefathers have given us? Every time we say that we should plant more and more trees, so that we can pass on to my posterities, our posterities. They should not be bereft of more oxygen. If we cut more trees, our children, our posterities will suffer immensely. They will undergo massive phase of destruction. So in order to save the world and humanity, we have to give something, not only utilize, but utilize less and give more to our generation who is coming following us, who is coming after us. So today I have just given four, rest it would be completed in three or four lectures. So this is the pattern in which you have to study. It would be very nice, read less, but read sumptuous. Read from the authentic source. The first source I gave you is NCERT books, and the second source is every year Malayalam Manorama is published or the India Yearbook. You just pick up and read chapter by chapter. As I am reading, similarly you should read and try to understand all the nuances. Ajanta Ellora, what are the things to remember, and then Fort, Taj Mahal. Similarly, you will develop a habit of reading and identifying the problems, identifying the areas and delineating those things which are crucially important for you to remember. Thank you very much.
यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम् अधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहम् परित्राणाय साधूनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थम्।